The topic for today is financial independence, and today we will dive deeper into how compounding can let you achieve financial independence. So financial independence to me, basically, I mean, you can define it in many ways. To me, that means independence from any activity that you have to do to pay your bills. So, your wealth should grow large enough so that, it competes with your own personal income. And at some point of time, you can hand over the baton to your, the wealth in your portfolio to earn for you, while you pursue your own interests and dreams. And that can also be, wealth generating. But that the purpose of doing that is not monetary or wealth to start with. So basically, to achieve a position where you are not worried about your daily finances or your retirement, but you are pursuing your passion and doing that well. And in most cases, I have seen, if you are doing that well, more wealth and more prosperity comes running after you. So the idea is to achieve this position and then enjoy what you actually like to do. So the three major factors which impact achieving financial independence are time, percentage of income invested, and CAGR. So each of these elements is very important independently, and we will see how with the combination of these three, with various combinations of these three, you'll be able to see how much wealth can be generated if one is systematically working towards that. So first pillar of this exercise is time. So we'll see how time is impacting your return. So let's say we started with a capital of 5 lakhs, the CAGR, let's say, assumed at 15%, and you're doing it for 30 years. Now, in year 5, 5 lakhs become 10 lakhs, year 10, 20 lakhs, year 15, 40 lakhs, 20 lakhs. But you will see that exponential growth will start to come at a later stage. And the hockey stick exponential curve is basically what gets you those huge gains. So within the first three hops, you went from 5 lakhs to 40 lakhs, and then in the next three hops, you went from 40 lakhs to 3.3 crores. So that is the kind of time impact on your achieving financial independence. So start early and give it time. I mean, that's what Warren Buffett has been doing all his life. But you can start at 25 and hope to achieve something great by 50, 55. And that is very much possible. The second pillar of this exercise is how much percentage of your income are you investing? So an example here, let's say, and these various trends are based on 10% of income, 20%, 30%, 40%, 50%. How much percentage of income are you able to save and invest? So let's say we are assuming you starting with 10 lakhs of income. I agree that this is not something that is possible at 25 for most people, but just for assumption's sake, let's start at that figure, 10 lakhs. Increase in income, let's say, is 5% year on year, which is very nominal. In fact, you should be able to get inflation adjusted at least 5% increase in your income every year. CAGR, assuming, let's say, 20%. This is aggressive, but we'll see how the third pillar, CAGR, is not so not the only reason why you'll do well. And let's say assume the number of years is 20. So starting at 10 lakhs, if you are investing 10% of your income every year and your income is growing 5% year on year, you'll end up at 2.3 crores in year 20. Whereas if you keep increasing the percentage of income you're investing from 10%, 20%, 30%, at 50% if income, if you're investing and your income is also growing, you will achieve a figure of 11.89 crores in 20 years. So just see the difference between a person who was saving less and a person who was saving more, that the difference is phenomenal, right? You could also start, with a lower saving at a lower absolute level. You are unable to save more, so maybe you can start with 10%. A few years down the line, you can you know, when your income goes up, but your expenditure, hopefully you're smart enough not to let it go in the same proportion. You know, you may come to 20%, then you may reach even 30% at some point. I know 50 is very, very difficult to achieve, but at times, if you are really growing well in your profession and careers, 50% is also not out of the norm. So you can see the impact of percentage of income invested is also huge. First, we saw time impact, then we saw percentage of income invested impact. The third impact is that of CAGR. This is, of course, you are all familiar with this, but I want to draw some very obvious correlations here. So let's first see what this example says. Let's you start at 10 lakhs and your income again is growing at 5%, time period is 20 years. So if you were investing 10% of your income and your average CAGR or CAGR is 15%, you achieve 1.3 crores at the end of 20 years, right? If it was 20%, you achieve 2.3. So just a 5% change in the CAGR makes your end capital go up by almost, you know, 45%. And another 5% almost doubled. And another 5% almost again, you know, 80-90% up. So this is the impact of CAGR regardless of what you're saving. But if you are able to combine a increasing investment percentage, and even if you were to remain at a lower CAGR, you are able to see that 10 lakhs would become 6.8 crores in 20 years, right? Even at 15% CAGR. So a lot of people are running after very high CAGRs, but I think you should run after higher percentage of income saving, reasonable amount of CAGR, and the time that you are allocating to it. So if you are super sort of aggressive, you know, maybe you can save a lot of money every month or every year and also do fantastic investing, get 30% CAGR, you will achieve 37 crores in 220 years. And these are all gross figures, not assuming taxation, etc., just for illustration purpose. But the idea is very, very clear that if you have a very high CAGR but low income, you achieve 7.4. But if you have a very high saving but low CAGR, you still achieve somewhere similar to that. Right. So you can go from low from high CAGR initially. You can take more risks when you are young and go to a lower CAGR as your wealth grows, to, you know, to preserve it also and not take undue risks, and also go from lower income saving to a higher income percentage saving every year. And of course, you have the time with you when you are young. So these are sort of the three pillars that you can work towards, which will help you achieve financial independence. So this was all that I had today in the Weekend Investing Bite. Hope you have a great weekend, and please don't forget to subscribe to the channel and look at all the links in the description below to take you to the right places in terms of our offerings. So thank you, and have a good weekend.